I'm out here at Coca-Cola Park speaking with Mike Schwimmer. Mike, your performance has been great, outstanding here with the Lehigh Valley Iron Pigs, 3-0 record. What can you tell me about your solid success this year?
Season's about half over, so not really counting anything right now. Kind of waiting to see how the season plays out, but right now I'm happy with my performance.
Now, last year, spent some time in Reading, Eastern League All-Star, things like that came your way. Is that something on your mind? Is that an honor you would really appreciate getting at the International League level as well?
Of course, it would be a great honor if I was named that. But it's really out of my control, to be honest with you. There's a lot of things that, you know, people decide. I don't know, the fans decide and the media decides that, like I said, is out of my control. So, of course, it would be a great honor. But if I'm not named an All-Star, it wouldn't be the end of the world for me.
Obviously, higher hopes than that, getting to the next level would be something you're looking toward more greatly. Do you feel like you're ready if you got that call around this time?
Yeah, I absolutely feel like I'm ready. I felt like I'm ready for a while, but honestly, like I said kind of before, it doesn't really matter how I feel. It matters how the scouts feel and the talent evaluators feel and our GM feels. So, you know, I hope that they feel that way, and I'm just going to keep pitching to the best of my ability, and hopefully that day comes soon.
Sure. Now, here in AAA, you got a lot of guys on the team that are moving up and down, that have moved up and down, that have been to the big league level. Out there in the bullpen with you, you got guys like Zagurski, Matheson's been here. Are those guys that you're able to learn from and maybe pick their brains a little bit to try to, you know, get an idea of what to expect and where you're going?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, those guys are great. Both those guys, Matheson and Zagurski. Also, Herndon came down, and Stoops is a good friend of mine, and, you know, I still talk with all of them, and, you know, it's been real great. Yeah, they've been incredibly supportive, helped me out any questions I've ever had or anything I've needed. They've always been there for me, and I'm truly appreciative of that.
I've talked to guys within the Philly system, a couple guys out of the system, and they'll cite intimidation factors when facing a guy that's of a much greater height than them. Do you ever run into that? Do you ever kind of maybe see a little intimidation towards maybe a shorter batter or certain batters that you face? You're 6'8" tall.
You have to ask the hitters that.
Yeah.
For me, you know, I don't see any of that, really. You know, it's hard to really tell. I'm sorry.
No, that's fine. That's fine. Pitching coach Rod Nichols here. Coaching staff speaks highly of you. What can you tell me about the coaching staff and Coach Rod?
Coach Rod's been great. He's been a huge, huge influence in my pitching career. He's helped me out a lot of little things. Hasn't really made a big adjustment with me in terms of my mechanics or what I do, but there's been a lot of little details he's been able to help me out with that have made all the world difference and is a huge factor in my season so far this year.
I know you're big into writing and connecting with folks online and things like that. What's been the best thing about, you know, connecting with people online and joining Twitter and writing blogs? That have helped you as you've progressed and built up towards where you're going?
Well, I just, you know, I do all that for the fans and stuff. I do that for, you know, there's so little people that know a lot about minor league baseball that I feel like as a player that's played in almost every level of minor league baseball, I can help the fans understand what we go through and what goes on and things like that. So, you know, I really do it, and, you know, we wouldn't be playing this game without fans, and I respect that and try to help them as much as possible.
I've coached Babe Ruth League age kids, age 13 to 15. You know, if you had an opportunity to speak to kids that age that were hoping to play baseball beyond high school, whether it's college or professionally, what advice would you give to kids that age?
Live out your dream. I'd give them two advices. First, live out your dream, and second, get an education, because you never know when your dream's going to come crumbling down on you, and you're going to need that education as a backbone. And that's one thing that I'm incredibly proud of. Probably the best thing I ever did was get a degree from the University of Virginia, and, you know, I could blow out tomorrow, today, and I'll have something to fall back on. And I really think that too often kids go through life and they just live in their dream one single track and have no backup plan. I think it's very important, and everybody's backup plan should be education. There's no excuse to not getting a good education. There's no excuse for not applying yourself in school so you can have that backup plan. It's really a huge safety net, and, you know, it's also easier for your dream. I'm able to live my dream right now with reckless abandonment. You know, had I not had that education,
right,
Now I've got so much pressure. So if I don't make it in baseball, I got nothing. You know, so that's really the advice I give them.
All right, Schwimmer, thank you so much for taking the time.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Appreciate it.